Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2465, How to Combine Multiple If Formulas. But then, episode 2465 and a half, Excel Lambda and I just shortened a formula by 99.8%. Can you beat that? And I'm sure some of you can. 12,000 characters of formula down to 16. All right, so here's our question. Our manager comes to us and says, hey, look, we have the number of units sold over here. Give everyone a score based on this. 15 to 29, you get a 1. 30 to 59, you get a 2. Greater than 60, you get a 3. If you didn't get 15, 0. Write a formula that's going to do this. Here is an approach to this. The first formula here in column CC is fairly simple. We're just looking over there in CB3. If it's less than 15, then you get 0. Otherwise, quote, quote, an empty cell. And then here, now this is the tricky one, right? Because we have two tests. You have to be greater than or equal to 15 and less than 30. So in order to put two tests inside the if statement, we have to wrap that in an and function. Now in this case, there's only two arguments, but you can have up to 254 arguments, and all of them have to be true in order for and to be true. All right, so this is where we're at 15 to 29, you get a 1, otherwise nothing. Test 3 is very, very similar. If we're greater than or equal to 30, less than 60, you get a 2. And then test 4 over here, if you're greater than or equal to 60, you get a 3, otherwise nothing. And then to put it all together, relatively new from February of 2017, the CONCAT formula. We'll put all those together. And of course, since only one of those can be true, you're going to get either 0, 1, 2, or 3. Not bad. In fact, if you're the person who created this, good for you, right? This is some fairly advanced Excel going on here. Using and, a lot of people don't know how to use and. I mean, you're above 80% of the Excel people at this point. And my term for this is a term that's very familiar in Britain and Australia. It's called, I'm chuffed to bits. That's not a term we use in America. I had to go look it up. But good for you if you wrote this. That is a really good formula. But we're going to make it better. I'm going to geek out here. And a friend of mine in Australia, Liam Bastick, has written several books, Introduction to Financial Modeling and then Continuing Financial Modeling. And they both have this great rule of thumb, right? And I'm stealing this from Liam, and he says he stole it from a colleague of his. The idea, the formula in your formula bar should be no longer than your thumb. And right now, we have a formula that's longer than that. You know, and I'll also go back when I was a judge at the Model Off. This is back in 2012, 2013. It was in New York City. They had the main competition, but then they also had this side bet. And it was a $5,000 prize for solving a puzzle with the shortest formula. You know, what's best? We're looking for the shortest length. But also, my rule, don't be a jerk, right? Don't come up with the shortest formula if no one will be able to understand it. And I'm going to admit that in this video, I'm going to have an unhealthy obsession with trying to get the shortest formula. You'll be warned in advance. Okay, so you might remember this from episode 2464. This kind of picks up exactly at the point where we are right now. The person who wrote these formulas, it's all working, good for you, trying to short it down into a single formula. And I'm not sure where they went wrong, adding this extra CB3 in here and here, and that didn't work. How to shorten this down if CB3 is less than 15. And then after that next if statement in the and function, you don't have to repeat CB3 again. And we come up with this 90 character formula. And that's impressive. Like using the rule of thumb, that's a 25% reduction in size. Went from 120 characters of formula up here down to 90. That's really good. But I think there's still one massive improvement that we can do. If you look at this, when it was separate columns, it made sense for you to have to do the test to make sure that we're greater than or equal to 15 and less than 30, but that's not necessary now. Once you know that it's not less than 15, you don't ever have to check for that again in the same formula. If it had been less than 15, we would have gotten a zero here. Here in this 90 character formula, when we go check to see, hey, is this greater than or equal to 15? We already know it is because we wouldn't have gotten to this part of the formula had this been true. In order to do what I'm suggesting here, you have to make sure that you start from the smallest and work your way up to the largest. But we can very easily take out all of these red characters here. We get shortened down to 77. And then out here, we don't have to test to see if it's greater than or equal to 30. We already know that it's greater than 30 because if it wasn't, it would have gotten either the 0 or the 1. So we wouldn't have made it to this point in the formula. And then finally, we don't have to check to see if it's greater than 60. if we get here, if we get to the value of false, it has to be greater than 60. Otherwise, it would have gotten one of these, right? So that is an impressive reduction in size from 120 characters down to 49, 59.2% reduction in size. And for those of you who are here to try and figure out how to do multiple ifs in a formula, this is where you should stop. That's the formula that I would recommend that you use. Very fast, very efficient. I have a course that you'll love out on the Retrieve platform, Ace Your Job Interview, where you have to know Excel. Again, for those of you who are here to figure out how to combine multiple ifs, thank you for stopping by. Stop back for another netcast from Mr. Excel. But for my regular viewers, I can already hear you saying, oh wait, we can do better than this. Do they really need these in quotes? The 0, the 1, the 2, the 3? We can save 8 characters right away by putting the numbers 0, 1, 2, and 3. It's probably more likely to be useful down the road to have those be real numbers instead of text numbers. So now we're down to a 65.8% reduction. And we can get even shorter by using a new function that came along in February 2017. Hey, you must have it because you were using CONCAT earlier. The plural version of ifs. This is cool. You don't have to nest multiple functions inside of each other. If CB3, that's the first test. If that's less than 15, then 0. And then the next test, if it's less than 30. Now, again, we wouldn't have gotten here if the first one wasn't true. Then we're 1. If CB3 is less than 60, then a 2. All right, now, hey, look, this is my unhealthy obsession. Technically, that 1 right there is supposed to say true, but that would cost me 4 characters to put a true there, and a 1 is the same as a true. So like this next to the last argument is always a true, and then what to do if the other stuff isn't true. So if we're greater than or equal to 60, then we get a 3, right? And now I'm down to 36 characters. And then it was Excel Lambda in a comment on yesterday's video that suggested this let, right? Lots of advantages to let because we get to redefine CB3 as the variable A, right? So that should save us 2 characters there, 2 characters there, 2 characters there. Unfortunately, the defining CB3, that costs us a few characters and it actually ends up being longer. I'm not casting any shade to Excel Lambda. It was an idea from Excel Lambda that's going to save us dramatic formula length coming up. You know where I said we should have stopped? I realize at this point that I am going insane. You have to ask the question, is there some clever math that we can just get rid of the whole if statement and solve the problem? So take this score, divide it by 15, send it into the int function, the integer function. Boy, and that works for 0, 1, 2, but right here at 45, because the manager was clever, kind of using something like a logarithmic scale here, not a true logarithmic scale, but you know, it's harder to get to a 3 than it was to get to a 2. This is not going to work. I'm gonna get 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 when I needed 0, 1, 2, 3. That would have been golden. 12 character formula, woohoo! That doesn't work because of the manager. But I could take this formula, which is gonna give me the number 0 through 4, add 1 to it, send it into the choose function, and then change that to 0, 1, 2, 2, 3. While this seems like a silly formula, it still is better than the ifs. The ifs was 36, and this is 32. Your coworkers will hate this. No one will be able to understand this. It violates the person has to be able to understand what's going on rule. I know so many people are gonna hate VLOOKUP. The person who sent this question in probably is not at the VLOOKUP stage, and everyone who's still watching at this point thinks I should be using index and match instead of VLOOKUP. But you have to admit the comma true version of VLOOKUP, which is great. You don't need the comma true at the end or the comma one at the end. It is the default, which most of the time I grumble about. So we just built our little table here. 0 gets you 0 points. 15 or higher gets you 1 point. 30 or higher gets you 2. 60 or higher gets you 3. Simple little VLOOKUP there. Down to 25 characters. That's a 79% reduction. Probably actually fairly easy to understand, except for you have to have a lookup table somewhere on the sheet. Joe McDade gave us XLOOKUP. It's far more robust. It's better in every way, except for this particular test, because I have to put the C2 to C5 range in there, and then the D2 to D5 with all the dollar signs ends up being a lot longer. And it's funny, we have to go back to Dan Bricklin and Bob Frankston and their lookup function from VisiCalc. It was a crazy function. You're looking up the 30. It's always comma true by default, and what you're returning is the last column of the lookup range. So it is an amazingly short formula there. 22 and 81.7% reduction. Let's just check for the index and match, folks. So we were at 22. The match gets us down to 25. It's nice that the match only needs a one column table with where are the breaks. That one there is actually optional because in the match, that's the default. So we can get down to 23, right? That's pretty good. It definitely beats VLOOKUP, but it doesn't beat LOOKUP. And again, XMatch, it defaults to an exact match. So we have to put the negative one in there. In both cases, it's returning an offset. We're not getting a zero where we need it. So unfortunately, none of the match or XMatch can beat LOOKUP. I did try and see what would happen if we embedded the table, all right? So let's just get rid of the table. And we're still at 26 instead of 22, so it's not the best formula. And then let's cheat a little bit. Let's name these ranges. Here's the first lookup table. Here's the other lookup table. Let's name them, right? So now a match with CB3 and is using the name of V. That gets us down to 15. Woohoo, that's the shortest. But then lookup. Lookup with this this range being called W, that gets us to 14, and that's an 88.3% reduction in size from the original 120. If we're really trying to win $5,000 at the Model Off competition back in 2013, this, I think, is the formula that I would come down to. Now, I know some of you watching this are gonna have something shorter, you're gonna have some crazy thing that I've never thought of, and by all means, please put it down in the YouTube comments. But it was Excel Lambda who gave me this idea yesterday. It's not just the 14 characters. It's not these 14 characters because, you know, we probably have 100 employees and we have to copy this formula 100 times. So it's not 14 characters, it's 1400 characters, right? So rather than have this and this and this and this and this and this and this on every row, let's do all of those lookups at once, right? So here, this awesome formula, equal lookup of the numbers, comma W, so we're using the named range. And that formula is a little bit longer, it's 16 instead of 14, but it's one formula that will return all of the results. 100 results, 1,000 results, whatever you throw at it. Really, when I said we were down to 14, we weren't down to 14, we were down to 1,400, assuming 100 rows of data, and now we just went from 1,400 to 16. Which is an astounding 99.867%. Now listen to me, right in that second title card, I'm claiming that Excel Lambda and I came up with this reduction. Let's be completely fair, I got us to 88.33, Excel Lambda got us the rest of the way, so good for you, Excel Lambda. If you have something better than this, and I'm sure you do, please, by all means, down below, let me know. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. Well, there you are, two videos all in one video. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Let us hear you, Nancy.